Oh, how about this for a tough decision early on? Which direction they go here is going to say a lot about what this team wants to do. Boy, you talk about a friendly turn of the cards. This is a great round for these guys as they get themselves a dynamic player right here. Excellent selection. Just what this team needs to maybe get them over the hump. Yeah, I think they got the best player there, and they got a guy that fills a big need, so that's an excellent choice. These middle rounds are where your decisions can really impact your team. Because if you pass on certain... Yeah, that's the kind of guy who can elevate that entire unit. He's a very talented addition. Yeah, here's a spot where the fan base would be clamoring for a skill player. But do you listen to him or go after someone who could help you up front? Where to now? Do you get yourself a big brute for the trenches or someone who can really help you out at the playmaking type spot? Some tough choices coming up right about now. Do you go after the best available player or do you go after a position of need? Boy, it's finger-crossing time now. With the end in sight and a few more holes to fill, you've got to be hoping that there's still a gem or two that becomes available. And there's a pick that does fill a hole, but I'm not sure that it's really going to be the one that improves the overall squad a tremendous amount. Always a tough decision, offense or defense. It's all about finding the right balance when you're putting a team together. It's the age-old question on draft day. What's the bigger need, offense or defense? Boy, it's finger-crossing time now. With the end in sight and a few more holes to fill, you've got to be hoping that there's still a gem or two that becomes available. Yeah, I think with that pick, you're just looking to build up your core. Get some guys in here that can help round out the roster. Right now you've reached the lineup screen. It might be...
A new era begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this...
And it's the birth of a new club as we're underway in Draft Champions. On the return, here's a speedy Jamison Crowder. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Here's McNabb. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Complete to Gilmore, the tight end. And he takes it down deep into Atlanta territory. A big play there for the Bears on third. And even 40 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Freeman again. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a 3rd and 8. 8th play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. And that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And the 13-year man puts it through, and it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. So they come into enemy territory. Nice drive to start the game, but they probably wanted 6. They only got 3.
I agree with you totally. That's the expectation. When you get the ball and you start moving it and you're rolling, you think you're going to end up in the end zone. But they should be happy with the 3. A good way to get things going here in this game.
First and 10, Cousins. And he hits on the slant route to Marshall. And he's brought down after a good gain. It's a gain of 20 that time. And the Falcons are going to get a first.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie,
you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part of... that play for him. I don't think that was his primary target.
No, I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now Cousins. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete. Challenge the ref.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player, you threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final.
It's caught inside the 25. A big connection on that one. 31 yards.
There we go now.
A first down throw for Cousins. Anunua's got it. Complete. He won't go down. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. So just a lone field goal in this first quarter of play. 3-0 alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Cousins again. Finding time. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Second down, Cousins steps away to his left. It's a gain of 5, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. Kirk Cousins taking it in. And the Falcons have taken the lead. That's an old-fashioned death march there, partner. Took them a lot of plays, but hey, they did the job.
And the defense always preaches getting off the field, making a play and turning it back over to their own offense. Unable to do so. A long, sustained drive by the offense.
Billy Cundiff now to kick the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point
kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him account.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jay Howard, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Second down, McNabb. Caught left side, Gilmore. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter because he has such great skills. You want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. On the catch, it's Crowder. A gain of 8 and a first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On the counter, Devontae Freeman. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Here we go. Grand 38.
On first and 10, McNabb. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. He had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped. To go here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Throw on second, McNabb. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Vince Wilfork coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. To throw, McNabb. Catch here, left side, Thomas. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
So on fourth down, here's Brad Nortman on to punt it away. Back deep, Ladarius Webb. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. So out come the Falcons now. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Cousins to throw it. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. They brought a man off the corner and he gets in to drop him for a loss of four.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
On second down, Anderson. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. So as they take it over, we step aside.
The Bears have put an extra defender in the secondary on third down.
Yep, they're in the nickel. And with time running down, they go down to a knee. And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. Final play of the half, Cousins taking a shot here for Marshall. And that's caught inside the 35. Never mind, Larry. Forget your halftime report. Apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken about the 12. Oh, the spin. Spinning again.
In a game like this, you're fighting, you're scratching, you're clawing, you're hammering away. That return has the feel of maybe cracking the rock and giving them a chance to get a big-time advantage.
They go play action here on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. So the flag is for the very rare illegal forward pass penalty.
Not often that a quarterback forgets where the line of scrimmage is. They have an innate sense about it. And this play, the quarterback did.
Now a run with Anderson. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I would not want to be an offensive lineman in today's NFL, especially not a center or a guard, if you got to deal with these massive defensive tackles who could not just beat you with strength, but they can beat you with quickness and guile as well. They can get upfield and make plays. And a lot of times what they're taught Just go ahead and tackle everyone that comes in your area and keep the ball with the ball. They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defense. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Well, that was a long attempt to begin with, so the fake you might have known was somewhat of a possibility. Credit to the defense, though. They weren't fooled.
You're right, they weren't fooled, and they were in a position of having to play it both ways. Guard for the fake, but you still want to rush the kicker because it was a makeable kick. So they ended up getting the best out of the whole thing. Stuffed the fake, and they take over the ball.
McNabb, he throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff,
didn't they? When we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Let's go!
Second down, McNabb. He's got time. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Crashing in from the end there, not to disrupt the pass game, but to disrupt the run game.
Yeah, I love the distinction, too, because the good defensive ends, they can do it all. Set the edge in the run game, make sure that no one can move it that way, and, of course, rush the passer. On that play, use his speed to get there in the run game.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
McNabb to throw. Complete to Gilmore over the middle. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. Great play there off the end. Question, Charles. In a 4-3, you hear about the D tackles a lot. What's the role of the ends?
What they want to do is control the edges of the defense. And you always hear about an offense talking about setting the edge in the running game. Well, the defense wants to do exactly the same thing. And the defensive end, often against an offensive tackle, sometimes a tight end, they can't let themselves get a hook and let a running back get outside. Because if they do that, that hurts the integrity of the defense overall.
My man, the encyclopedia. To throw, McNabb got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Quincy Enunwa, a 5-yard touchdown, and the Bears have retaken the lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one taken from the 7. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
And some room to work. And he is finally going to be stopped down around the 5-yard line. What a return.
all praises for a tremendous return, but how about the guys that never gave up on the play, refused to let him get into the end zone, and tracked him down before he got there and made the tackle? A lot of pride exhibited by guys on special teams.
Now a play fake here on first down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Kyle Williams able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss, not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense.
It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
He goes underneath for Anderson, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. C.J. Anderson, a 5-yard touchdown, and the Falcons have once again taken the lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. First down, it's McNabb. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. And they'll give it to him here. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down. Now in Foxborough, it's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter.
Here we go.
The play fake. Now McNabb. He's got pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. And the defense coming through on third down, a loss of seven to bring up fourth. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well, and that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
That's taken on the 25. Whoosh. Still on his feet. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the offense will come back onto the field with a first and 10. In the backfield is Anderson. They go play action here on first down. And that's complete to Marshall on the crossing route. Touchdown, Falcons! Their big-bodied receiver, 52 yards. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Good pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. It took him less time than that to get to top speed and complete that play.
They certainly made quick work of that, ultra-quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see. Just one play resulting in the touchdown. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. Now it's Crowder. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. First and 10, McNabb. And that's complete to Gilmore. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Second down, McNabb surveying the field and seeing nowhere to throw. He chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
And he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. McNabb. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by the longtime Bengal, Leon Hall.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Following the interception, Cousins. Wide open, it's Marshall, complete. 19 yards that time for number 19. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Now a play fake here on first down. Being chased out left. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Red zone opportunity. In the backfield is Anderson. Cousins to throw it. Give them 13 on the pickup there. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal.
Here go. Green three.
Cousins. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. Michael Crabtree, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football.
Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Vic Beasley able to drop him for a loss of a couple. And back at the 8 now. Third and goal. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Cousins. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. So on fourth down, Marvin Lewis sends on the field goal unit from the left hand. Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That'll wind up going for a loss of four.
I remember being taught that cliches have become so for a reason. A lot of times they're true, right? What's that they used to tell us about letting sleeping dogs lie? But this one wasn't sleeping, maybe just slumbering a little bit. But taking that gamble there, you've got the lead. You may have ignited them now they stopped you.
That's exactly right. If you take the points here, you don't shift momentum necessarily on that play. You probably just did. To throw on second, McNabb, complete to Gilmore over the middle. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. From the gun, here's McNabb. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And they're going to speed things up here. To throw, McNabb. Got an open man, it's a noon one. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down throw, McNabb, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Second down, McNabb. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
The defensive coordinator came into this game with a plan to get to the quarterback with whatever type of pressure is necessary. It's working to perfection for him today.
Out of the gun, McNabb. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he's brought down, but not before getting across midfield to the 45. And now they're in the hurry up. McNabb to throw. Right side catch, Gilmore. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. To throw on second, McNabb. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third. Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8. From the gun, here's McNabb. This is going to be incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Crockett Gilmore, there. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
And that incompletion was caused by the defense. I think they were trying to get one into the middle of the field, trying to find a receiver there. But they were in zone defense, and what are the advantages of being...
That's caught inside the 20. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He goes underneath to Freeman, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Call it a gain of 5, and it's a second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. One final shot, they'll look to throw, and that will be incomplete. As time has run out on this.
a successful start to the new campaign. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Draft Champions. The Falcons come in.
Two teams here amped and ready for football, and off we go in week two of Draft Champions. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here come the Chiefs for their own.